So next up, we have Andrea Powell. She's the Executive Director of Publishing at Cavi. Some of you will know, I think, for all her work on the STN board and in Alps. You might have known she's a passionate supporter of Reading football, soccer team, so I discovered earlier. And she's going to speak about something called Plantwise, which I gather is the new farm film.
Possibly. Who knows? Who knows? Yes. Thank you very much. Yes, so now for something completely different. Thanks, Kim. So, factoid, it's a shocking fact that 40% of the food that we grow in this world is lost to pests and disease before it can be harvested. If we could reduce those losses by just 1%, we could feed 25 million more people. So Plantless is all about losing less, Plantwise, lose less, feed more people. Cabi has been very active in agriculture for over 100 years now, so we have an enormous amount of subject expertise, particularly in the area of plants and pests. And we felt we could bring together our publishing skills with that subject expertise to do something really special. Plant clinics. We have been running plant clinics now for many years in developing countries. What happens, the farmer comes along, he brings his plant, his disease plant, with its symptoms, just like you might go to the doctor. But until now, the information that's been given out has not been systematically recorded. So what happens if we could do that? If we could capture the data in a structured format from our plant clinics, what could we do if we scaled it up? How could we make a database full of actionable information that would really make a difference to food security worldwide? So we take all of the data uploaded, all the data gathered at clinics, we blend it with information that's harvested from a wide range of other sources, and we boil it down to data points that relate to the location of plants and the diseases and the pests that affect them at any given time. And that forms the basic element of our Plantwise Knowledge Bank. What can it do? Well, the data points that can be harvested and then plotted onto maps, as you see here, they can be filtered to provide different views of data, and they can be supplemented with information from other data sets, such as our crop protection compendium, as you see there. Now, this information has to be trustworthy. It has to come with an audit trail of its origins. And so we link all data points back into the research literature using our CAB Abstracts database. The Knowledge Bank also provides regionally specific on-the-ground tools to support the plant clinics and the doctors. Workflow tools such as image-based diagnostics, region-specific local language information, and access to other tools such as a list of approved suppliers and treatments. What's important is that the plant clinic, the Plantwise Knowledge Bank also provides clinic administration tools. Now, that ensures that the information that we gather is structured in a consistent way, but it also means that the doctor there has an incentive to provide his information because it helps him do his job more easily. So the clinic's data, when it's combined with other global data sets, such as climatic zones, soil characteristics, land use, water data, can give us a massive, massive data set with very rich situational awareness, and we can derive any number of insights from it. Well, we have nearly 300 clinics currently up and running on a regular basis worldwide, but we are planning to expand this dramatically over the coming years. Now, that's going to create massive amounts of data. The more you put in, the bigger your big data, and the more sophisticated the analysis you can do, such as coffee wilt disease. This is a soil-borne fungal disease, which is a massive problem to coffee farmers in Africa. Thanks to our data gathering, we've got some very, very strong information, granular data, about where this disease exists in Uganda, and we know what the soil types are like in Uganda, and therefore we can overlay the two and create some very interesting patterns, which helps us to develop predictive maps showing where we think coffee wilt disease might next make its appearance. We can use this data to rapidly build pest risk tools for any combination of pests and countries, which can then help to direct research efforts more effectively and also to inform the global food supply chain, governments, and policy. The fingerprints of pests in a country is a good stand-in for reams of data about the habitats there. And when combined with further data sets, such as pathway data, which identifies how pests and diseases travel from one country to another, you can really start to build up a predictive index saying where they might appear next. Once you start to gather data on a major scale, you can start to interpret and analyze that data to find out how to make the service more effective, such as all the criteria on the left here. This kind of analysis is essential in the development context because it helps us to identify whether our work is ever actually making a difference. Now, this is all the technical stuff that I'm no expert on, but apparently there's a very large relational database sitting underneath all of this. And the modular architecture allows us to plan for future expansion of the system. We use lots of third-party data through APIs. Now, a really important element of the PlantWise database is that all the content, all of the data points are validated by our Captosaurus, which is 130,000 terms and phrases. That's our ontology. Now, this is essential to ensure consistency and discoverability. You may be wondering how we're paying for all of this. Well, at the moment, our business model is donor funding. We've raised £30 million for the whole PlantWise initiative to date. But we fully anticipate that we will be able to generate revenue-generating products as our data set grows. And my time's up, and all I want to say is never let anybody tell you that publishers don't add value.